Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be going over some 2D drawing techniques, how to draw parallel projections, and 1-point, 2-point, and 3-point perspectives. So let's get into it. So in this video, I'm going to be using SketchUp as my tool for constructing these drawings. However, I just want to be clear that these are really 2D drawing techniques. So if you're going to do it on a computer or you're going to do it by hand, the same principles apply. I actually tried to record this video by drawing it by hand, but I actually hurt my hand and the drawings weren't turning out very well. So I figured I'll just show the principles using SketchUp as a 2D drawing tool. So the first thing that we want to do is draw a parallel projection. So basically that's covers a wide range of things. The first thing to note is just that there is no vanishing point like there would be in a perspective, like we'll show in 1-point, 2-point, and 3-point. Basically your lines are just parallel. So you have three axes, you have your Z, your X, and your Y. All the lines in the x-axis are going to be parallel, all the lines in the y-axis are going to be parallel, and all the lines in your z-axis are going to be parallel. Now, depending on the angle, it could define it as like an isometric. Like an isometric drawing has a specific set of angles where the x-axis and the y-axis and the z-axis are. But parallel projection just will cover all of that. I'm going to keep the z-axis vertical, and then just sort of pick a random angle here. And then what you do is I can actually just select these lines, draw them all in the same direction. And I could even take this line here and copy it because all of these lines are exactly the same because I'm just drawing a box here. But you can see that these lines in this axis are all parallel, and that's how it gets its name. Now for a 1-point perspective, you'll end up having a horizon line. And depending on where you draw from will depend on the angle that you want to see the object from. So let's draw a huge X here. Actually, let me just draw this off to the side. So I'm just going to draw this X. And then do that. And let's scale it down. And I'll just make this a group. So we'll use these for our actual drawings. So we have 1 point in 1-point perspective. So if I want to, so I still have vertical lines here. And I'll just draw some vertical lines. So let's say we want the front to be flat. Then you would take these lines and you'd connect it here. Now this other axis, so we have one axis that is in a direction. And the other ones are all parallel. So for this particular instance, I'm doing this sort of like flat. So that's a 1-point perspective. And let me just show you a different way to do that. And it doesn't really matter here if, you know, if my z-axis is there, and let's say that's there, it's the same thing. Yeah, I just have to make sure that this is parallel with that, and this is parallel with this. And then this, obviously, in perspective is going to get a lot smaller, but the same principles apply. You can see there that I don't actually need that line or this one because it's covered up by the geometry itself. So yeah, the angles don't really matter for that. How you're going to have your parallel projection. It doesn't have to be directly vertical or horizontal. It can be skewed. But what happens when you do that is just is going to skew your box the way that it looks. Let's move this over and we'll do a 2-point perspective. For 2-point perspective, you're going to have vertical lines in the Z direction. And then on one side, everything is going to go to this point here. And this side, everything is going to go to the other point. Now, these points can move along that horizon line however you want. You can move it closer. You can move it further. It's just based on how you want your perspective to be. Another thing to notice is that This line here, this horizon line, is actually the eye of your viewer. The more that you, like if I had a door here, maybe I want the top of the door to land somewhere around here. A door is about 6'8". Maybe my height of my person is 6 foot. So I want it to be the height of my door to be a little bit above that line so that it's sort of mimicking reality in some respects. We're just going to start drawing here, and I'm going to try to draw something that is similar to, let's say an office building or something like that, maybe a retail store. So we're going to go to here. Now take this line, just go across. I'm just going to draw something like that, just so we have that reference point of where our door might be. So let's put a door here and here. Now this is kind of where things start to get a little tricky, because when we start, we're going to this side, but now we need to go back to this side because we're drawing a line that's going this way. So it's simple, but it can just get really kind of confusing really quickly. If you're not careful, delete this guy, delete that guy. I'm gonna just extend this all the way up. And maybe we do some, there's like a cornice or something up here. Let me see. And another thing to just sort of think about as you do this is I could equally space these. So if I do 5, these are equally spaced, but actually as your perspective goes, this one will be the longest, and this one will be the second longest. Kind of like that. And we'll move this one down a little bit, because your things just sort of vanish a little bit, or they get smaller as they go further back. So that looks okay. It's not perfect, but I'm sure there's some mathematical way of calculating the perspective for this. And then let's just get in this other side here, just so we have something else. Continue this to here. Get in our vertical line. Maybe this building is kind of thin. It's long and thin. So then maybe we do some kind of like, maybe there's a storefront on this side. Keep a nice column at the end and down here. Then maybe this is all glass. Maybe there's a... Use this point as our reference. And then, you know, if we want to push this in a little bit, maybe this goes in just a little bit. Say there's like a reveal here, so we'll connect this. Right? And then this comes up. So you're basically just connecting everything. Now, because this line is above, you're going to see the bottom of that. So that's just like one check for you to make sure that you're in the right direction. I just want to make sure that I go all the way across. Delete some of these extra lines. So then we have this little pushed in area, and you can see obviously this isn't in perspective, or it isn't an actual model, it's just a 2D drawing. But it gives you the sort of view as if you were looking at this in parallel projection. Now, I'm using SketchUp, which is kind of bizarre, to do this because I can just model it in 3D. But if you're constructing something, you know, like a really quick concept or something, you may want to do this rather than actually modeling everything. And it's pretty easy once you get the hang of it just to pump these out pretty quickly. So I'm not going to go through and make a whole building here, but that's two-point perspective and gives convincing views. Now, the last one that I'm going to talk about is three-point perspective. In three-point perspective, you have your two points like you had in the previous two-point perspective, but then you actually have a third point, which can be either be above this horizon line or below. And basically, that becomes your line for your z-axis. So you'll have a vertical line that goes up from that point, and then everything sort of stems off of that. So you have here, but if you draw this line, instead of it coming down to here, and you'll have this. So like if this is a city block or something, you can see how this starts to look like a building. So we'll just extend these up a little bit. So that gives that kind of illusion that you're looking at an aerial image or something of a building. So you might, I don't know, see a bunch of little lines that come down. And then there are little windows that come across. Let's say the top is pretty big. I'm just going to delete my perspective line here, and I'm going to delete the horizon line because I don't need that anymore. But yeah, for everything, you sort of do that. And as you go across, let's say we want to do some kind of like city block or something, and we're looking at this from about, I mean, I guess our horizon line is our eye level, so we're looking at it here. And if you wanted to see the top of that, let's say, okay, well, we don't actually want to see... We don't want to be looking at the top. We want it to look like we are actually flying above this building. So, and I want to see the top of it. So we'll connect these lines. And you can see we get this little square here, which would then be the top of our building. So we can delete these other lines. Now we have the top of the building. So maybe there's like a parapet there, so you know, if we want to do that, we draw down to there because that's our vertical axis, and then maybe if we want to go here, we connect to this line and then just extend that out so it's perpendicular. Let's start somewhere like here, connect. So I'm just drawing like the offset kind of at the top. And again, just as you do this, you just want to sort of think about, you know, I'm doing these lines kind of arbitrarily, but you want to think about how the perspective would actually look. Let me get rid of this line because it's actually not at the where I drew the corner. So as things get further, they'll get smaller as they're further away. So you just want to sort of think about that as you're going through this. Things that are closer to you will be wider. And that's really the, everything else is kind of done for you as you go through this. So like this, I want it to be a little bit fatter, and this a little bit fatter than these two. Just because in perspective, that's what it'll look like. Let's go to here. Then this guy, I'm going to come over to here, but actually that line needs to come to there. Then use that intersection point to come here, and then hold shift so that I can continue that perspective out. Then I can get rid of this, these lines. So you can see now we have a building that has this little parapet, or I guess a big parapet on the top. That's basically how you go about drawing a three-point perspective. You know, if you want to add another building, let's say we want a little alley here, but we want a building here. Let's say it's a long, fat building. So I'm just using these tick marks as an indicator. What you would do is you would... just draw your vertical lines here. Maybe it's smaller, so we'll come to here and here and here. Now it can get really messy and you can get lost really quickly when you're drawing these kind of perspectives. So it just is a good practice to delete them, to delete those lines sooner rather than later, just so you don't get so confused about what's going on. Because I know that happens to me, and especially when I was first learning to draw these. I remember being in art class being really confused about, thinking that I had to start all over because I had drawn in the wrong direction. So you just want to be kind of diligent about that as you draw, just getting rid of some of the extra lines that you don't need. So, hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.